described and captioned media program. In the classroom and on the go. DCMP.org.
AMBROSE Video Publishing Incorporated presents Domesticated Bliss, the story of livestock in America.
The animals did well on Hispaniola because the local diseases did not affect them. There was an unlimited amount of feed and few predators. They reproduced at an extraordinary rate, and within 10 years, they had taken up residence on most of the Caribbean islands.
Bert stands in the field.
Strangely enough, the first colony in the Caribbean was considered a failure because the explorers didn't find any gold. But the domesticated livestock that they brought in ended up ensuring the success of all future Spanish colonies in the Americas.
The herd is led along a trail.
The domestication of animals began about 10,000 years ago with the reindeer and the dog. It wasn't until someone decided to stay put, grow crops, and live in one place that animals were bred in captivity and put to use.
A dog runs around a herd to keep it together.
Most people assume that we domesticated animals for economic reasons. Cattle is a source of meat and milk. Sheep is a source of wool. But that may not actually be the case.
Professor Daniel W. Gade, Ph.D.
If you go back to the archaeological record on some of these animals, you realize that they had very important cultic religious associations. So that, for example, the cattle were very strongly associated in their early stages of domestication with the lunar goddess cult because of the lunar or moon-like arrangement of their horns. And so they became symbolic for the cult purposes. And as a result of that, then they were bred in captivity as a way of getting more animals for the cult.
Title: Home on the Range or in the Oven. A cowboy rides hard to lasso a calf.
Southern Spain was the only place in Europe where open range cattle ranching on horseback was a tradition.
The calf is stopped with a rope around its horns.
Herding on horseback, branding cattle, and driving beef to market were all developed during the Middle Ages by Spanish cattlemen. The huge open rangelands in the Americas were just what the Spaniards understood, and they covered them with their cattle and horses. In a world with few natural predators and an endless food supply, their livestock multiplied at rates unimaginable in Europe.
Several cattle run by a palm tree.
The Spanish produced breeding herds in the Caribbean and Mexico, and by 1565 on ranches in Florida. Scottish Highlanders and black slaves from West Africa set up open cattle ranges in the Low Country of South Carolina.
The Described and Captioned Media Program provides services designed to benefit students who are blind, visually impaired, deaf, hard of hearing, and deafblind. These services include a library of free loan described and captioned educational media, a clearinghouse of information related to educational media access, a gateway to internet resources related to accessibility, and a set of guidelines for adding descriptions and captions to media. There are no user registration or service fees. Visit the DCMP at dcmp.org. The DCMP is funded by the U.S. Department of Education and administered by the National Association of the Deaf.